Hey, welcome back. I was just looking at the, demographics, I guess you could call it, of the line. And right now, one side is lopsided and the other side is stacked full of people. So with that aspect in play, when the trains, they haven't evened out the way they're supposed to. So like here, the passengers are stacked heavily towards one side of the line, and they all want to go towards, depending on where they are in the line, they all want to go one way or the other. So like right here, they all want to go stay on this side. And I think capacity is an issue sometimes when you get to a city with a lot of people. See, this has 450. Let's see. And it's going to let off about roughly 100. Pick up 100, but you see how that's not going to fly. Still got 600 people waiting. And my, the solution, I believe, is to add bigger, make the trains bigger so they can hold more. But not only that, have more trains so they can hold more. See, there's a lot of capacity. But it's like when they get to these stations, like 100, I don't know why there's any for Baton Rouge, from Baton Rouge, but apparently there's 20. Even got one person going to Mobile the other way, which is up here. In order to get there from here, you need to go through all of this. So I'm thinking there's going to be some intermediary lines that I'm going to create based on those statistics. All right, that was a nice amount of people. But you see there's like these long periods of time where there aren't anybody getting moved. Alright, so we're at the medium-sized ones. Now there's two things we can try. We can either try adding more trains on the line of the medium size, or we up it to big ones. And they hold like 560 people a piece. And all it takes is one train, really, to move all these people. As long as they all get off on one side. like every month it takes an extraordinary, it's like a 20 million dip. I don't know what that's all about. So we're in August and we're still at minus. That's not... Why does... upgrading the size and well, now I knew right from the beginning that I was going to have these kind of problems with this type of setup because of how long it is. And really, I mean, you're just going to get five cities down the line and your train's going to be full, so... but I still think we need more. This and the rate are good, but the spread is bad. See, we need to have some going this way and the other half coming this way. So we're down to 22 mil. Wow, 18, 20. Yeah, we might have been premature. Whoa. Twenty is about as low as we can go. Start going the other way. Come on. We might be like right on the edge of being able to have these medium trains at all. It looks like we're starting to go back up now. So what I'm gonna suggest at this point is that we go down to the small trains and we add five more. But I don't know. Seem to be climbing the other direction at the moment. That'll be hard on the growth to go back down. But what I want to do really is have an airport like right in here. have it hooked up to an airport right in here. Because it's going to be the end of the line. Jacksonville or New Orleans, whichever way you want to look at it. And then one up in Detroit. Like right here. Alright, and we'll have that hooked up in a tri-line, like just a big triangle. Alright, I'll be right back. We'll see if we rebound or not. Right, we're working our way up. Looks that way, anyway. You can see the stacks of people kind of shift. Like there aren't any over here anymore. And this area's been barraged by trains. Our income's a lot less, I think, based on the size of the trains. But let's get back to the lecture at hand. We're going to let it stabilize and I'm going to explain. I mean, each time it fluxes, it's going to get more and more money to it. We're going to expand now from Columbus, which is struggling. Columbus is definitely struggling. And we're just gonna sit back for 1 year and we're gonna let you see how much money we make without spending any really extra money. Oh, we already did that. Oh, well, not really, but... See, we're definitely not making as much money as we would have been without those, with the small trains. Small trains would have made more money because they cost less money. And then we gotta start thinking about industry. Like I said, we're probably gonna do construction materials, fuel, and food. Alright, we're gonna do middle, and we are going to switch back. Biddy biddy pop, biddy boop, biddy bang. Oh, nice. See, now all, look at that. That is pretty freaking spectacular. It's all kind of going one way or the other kind of thing. Perfect timing. One, two. Wow, still growing, New Orleans. Pretty smooth, man, it's good. Should I just go straight up to 50? Or no, we're gonna stop with the growth until we get this area sorted out. Thunder, what are you doing, Thundero? Hey, come out. Come out of there. Hey, buddy, I want to be able to see you. You know what I might be forced to do eventually, hopefully not too soon, is make another line. And then have everything be built, the depot be built over here on this side. Or maybe we just do it with the same line and just add trains on this side. So we're back to the small Tron-like train. Looks like Memphis is the extent of the reach of New Orleans. So from New Orleans to Memphis. Let's see how many cities we got incorporated. So that's about right. We could probably do two more. Hey, baby. Hey. You can't stand in the window like that. Yeah? Okay, I think we're getting better as we go here. And I believe, I mean, this is just a theory of my own, that the more often a train comes through and drops people off, the more off, you know, the better off the bus lines are. But as you can see, the farther we got out, the more, you know, costly this stuff is. Huh. Probably actually do with like two more. I was already speaking about this, but we got 21 cities, two trains per city. Going, one going this way and the other coming back. What I really need here is like a fleet, just a fleet of trains that'll cut these stacks down every time they come through. and for no area of this line to be any more populated with trains than another part. That's the other thing. Look at how well Windsor has responded to having a boat dock, train station, and a bus line inside of it. Look at that. That is exponential growth. Let's see what, yeah, booyah. Right now we only got two bus lines making any money, and one of them's not a bus line, it's a boat dock. Talishwassee, doing quite well, considering I basically just made this one. Can't wait to get Havana, Savannah, and Jacksonville hooked up. Havana's doing well. Fort Wayne needs a little help. See, right now, there should be trains here. There's no trains here. Right here. So that means we need more. We need a few more trains. Oh no. Fort Wayne, Detroit, Windsor, Cleveland, Columbus, Detroit. Fort Wayne, nice. Oh my god, I didn't even have it set up like optimally. I'm glad I looked at that. Just a random chance that I was to be looking at that and noticed that. So I'm glad that happened. My baby's so cool. His sister's cool too. Alright. I guess when we're making $162 million on the line, we're gonna... I've had lines that make roughly 305 mil. So, and they're a lot shorter than this one by like 5 city lines. Yeah, we're gonna have to totally upgrade. But I wanna get a, just making money first. Three stops in there. Should be good. Let's test it. Wow, look at that. I wasn't even paying attention. 237 million. This is probably going to end up being one of my more profitable lines after looking at that. All right, so my line. But as soon as when it gets way up there, we're going to watch what happens to it when we add on more cities and more trains. Keep an eye out. We'll get our people movers going. I hate making the double long ass tracks because there's like really increased probability that you're gonna screw them up. And if you screw them up, you gotta break them down and start over. This one's gonna be short if it works at all. Yeah, it'll work. Nice. That's what I like about the crazy checks, is they're cheap and they pretty much do what you want them to do. You see, we're gonna go up, we're gonna get Ottawa. Then we're gonna cut down to Allentown, Philadelphia, all the way down the side here like this. Put an airport right there. Hopefully that'll work. I mean, they are technically connected by this line here, but I don't know. Don't have a plan for including Toronto, but we will attempt anyway without a plan. That's Buffalo. And then we'll get our, we'll bang in bus lines. We really don't want to do this without them. Yeah, this is going to be quite any Audi type of line right here. Now we got two connections broken down, we're gonna pause it. We're gonna get this out here. I like making bridges whenever I can, but sometimes you just don't have the space, unless you demolish. Yeah, that's really close, but I think it'll work. then we'll put that connection back together. Now that seems like a really weird line to have. Columbus to Pittsburgh to Buffalo. And I mean, even though it's a much bigger line, that's what that little segment is. It's essentially. But. All right, we're gonna do our signals now. We'll add that section to it. Wonder. Baby. Sorry for yelling at you. Good. You see, this, having it like this leaves room for like direct connections if we want to do that. But for every direct connection that we make, the main line becomes less profitable. Because there is a finite amount of people in this game, basically. I know it seems like it's infinite, and the more cities you hook up, you know, the more money you get, but there's a limit. There's a range that is applicable. And it's mainly reflected in the, let me show you. There's a percentage, a pie worth of people, population. 0% of the population of this city, which is 1,087, is being shuttled around to other cities by your transportation. So, we're gonna make a bridge. Try to get it on the way back though. On the way back though. Where'd we leave off? Columbus. Gotta go all the way back to Colombo. So I thought the pink was, you know, a clever name for the series here. For obvious reasons, I called it the pink. Alright, let's see. Let there be light. And it looks like, you know, all the cities that were being hit from both sides, like Cleveland, Detroit, Fort Wayne, that had a there and a back involved in their stations via have exponentially more growth than those that didn't. I'm just gonna put this in real quick. I know I put a lot of effort into the other ones, but this just seems... I mean, I'm gonna look. But... okay, so there's a little bit that isn't covered. Section right here, that one building right there, I call that good. Rock and roll. I am gonna put another come on, get back, babe. It's cold. Thunder. Hey, baby. Alright guys, I'm going to be right back in another video. I hope you're enjoying my exploration of the United States. Yep, thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Peace out.